I've tinkered at my bits of rhymes in weary, woeful waiting times, in doleful hours of battle din, ere yet they brought the wounded in. Through vigils of the fateful nights, in lousy barns by candlelight, in dugouts sagging and a flood, on stretchers stiff and bleared with blood. By ragged grove, by ruined road, by hearths accursed where love abode, by broken altars, blackened shrines, I've tinkered in my bits of rhymes. I've solaced me with scraps of song, the desolated ways along, through sickly fields all shrapnel sown, and meadows reaped by death alone, by blazing cross and splintered spire, by headless virgin in the mire, by gardens gashed amid their bloom, by gutted grave, by shattered tomb, beside the dying and the dead were rocket green and rocket red, in trembling pools of poising light, with flowers aflame festooned the night. Ah me, by what dark ways of wrong, I've cheered my heart with scraps of song. So here's my sheaf of war-won verse, and some is bad, and some is worse, and if at times I curse a bit, needn't read that part of it. For through it all, like horror runs the red resentment of the guns. And you yourself would mutter when you took the things that once were men and sped them through that zone of hate to where the dripping surgeons wait. Wonder too if in God's sight war ever, ever can be right. Yet may it not be crime and war, but effort misdirected are. And if there's good in war and crime, there may be in my bits of rhyme, my songs from out the slaughter mill. So take or leave them as you will. Hark to the call of war, over the gorse and the golden dells, ringing and swinging of clamorous bells, praying and saying of wild farewells. War, war, war. High and low, all must go, hark to the shout of war. Leave to the women the harvest yield, gird ye men for the sinister field, a saber instead of a scythe to yield. War, red war. Rich and poor, lord and boor, hark to the blast of war. tinker and tailor and millionaire, actor in triumph and priest in prayer, comrades now in the hell out there, sweep to the fire of war. Prince and page, sod and sage, hark to the roar of war. Poet, professor and circus clown, chimney sweep and pop of the town, into the pot and be melted down, into the pot of war. Women all hear the call, the pitiless call of war. Look your last on your dearest ones, brothers and husbands, fathers, sons. Swift they go to the ravenous guns, the gluttonous guns of war. Everywhere thrill the air, the maniac bells of war. There will be little of sleeping tonight. There will be wailing and weeping tonight. Death's red sickle is reaping tonight. War, 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 war. I'm going to join the colors, Dad. They're looking for men, they say. But you're only a boy, young fellow, my lad. You aren't obliged to go. Well, I'm 17 and a quart of Dad, and ever so strong, you know. So you're off to France, young fellow, my lad, and you're looking so fit and bright. I'm terribly sorry to leave you, Dad, but I feel that I'm doing right. God bless you and keep you, young fellow, my lad, you're all of my life, you know. Don't worry, I'll soon be back, dear Dad, and I'm awfully proud to go. Why don't you write, young fellow, my lad? I watch for the posts each day, and I miss you so, and I'm awfully sad, and it's months since you went away. And I've had the fire in the parlor lit, and I'm keeping it burning bright, till my boy comes home, and here I sit into the quiet night. What is the matter, young fellow, my lad? No letter again today. Why did the postman look so sad and sigh as he turned away? Well, I hear them tell that we've gained new ground, but a terrible price we've paid. God grant my boy that you're safe and sound, but oh, I'm afraid, afraid. They've told me the truth,
young fellow, my lad, you'll never come back again. Oh God, the dreams and the dreams I've had, and the hopes I've nursed in vain. For you passed in the night, young fellow, my lad, and you proved in a cruel test of the screaming shell and the battle hell that my boy was one of the best. So you'll live, young fellow, my lad, in the gleam of the evening star, in the wood note wild, in the lap of the child, in all sweet things that are. And you'll never die, my wonderful boy, while life is noble and true. For all our beauty and hope and joy, we will owe to our lads like you.
Tried to tell me that was nothing but the thrumming of a woodpecker rapping on the hollow of a tree. And she thought that I was fooling when I said it was the drumming of the mustering of legions, and was calling unto me, was calling me to pull my freight and hop across the sea. And a mending of my fishnets, sure I started up in wonder, for I heard a savage roaring, and 'twas coming from afar. Oh, the wife, she tried to tell me that was only summer thunder, and she laughed a bit sarcastic when I told her it was war. 'Twas the chariots of battle where the mighty armies are. Then down the lake came half Tom with russet sail a-flying, and the word he said was war again, so what was I to do? Oh, the dogs, they took to howling, and the missus took to crying, as I flung my silver foxes in the little birch canoe. Yes, the old girl stood a-blubbing till an island hid the view. Says the factor, Mike, you're crazy, they have soldier men aplenty. You're as grizzled as a badger, and you're 60 years or so. But I haven't missed the scraps, says I, since I was 21. Shall I miss the biggest? You can bet your whiskers no. So I sold my furs and started, and that's 18 months ago. For a joint foreign, and they put me for a starter in the trenches of the Argonne with the Boches step away. And the partner on my right hand was an Apache from Montmartre, and on my left there was a millionaire from Pittsburgh, USA. Poor fellow, they collected him in bits the other day. But I'm sprier than a chipmunk, save a touch of the lumbago, and they calls me old Methuselah and blahs me all the day. I'm their exhibition sniper, and they work me like a dago, and laugh to see me plug a Boche a half a mile away. Oh, I hold the highest record in the regiment, they say. They gather round me and I tell them of my roaming in the country of the Crepuscle beside the frozen sea, where the muskox runs unchallenged and the caribou goes homing, and they sit like little children just as quiet as can be. Men of every crime and color, how they hearken unto me. And I tell them of the fur land, of the tump line and the paddle,
of secret rivers loitering that no one will explore. And I tell them of the ranges, of the pack strap and the saddle, and they fill their pipes in silence and their eyes beseech for more. While above the star shells fizzle and the high explosives roar. And I tell of lakes fish haunted where the big bull moose are calling, and forests still as sepulchres with never trail a track, and valleys packed with purple gloom and mountain peaks appalling. And I tell them of my cabin on the shore at Fond du Lac. And I find myself thinking, sure I wish that I was back. So I brag of bear and beaver while the batteries are roaring, and the fellows on the firing steps are blazing at the bow. And I yarn of fur and feather when the mommies are soaring, and they listen to my stories. Seven poilu in a row, seven lean and lousy poilu with their cigarettes aglow. And I tell them when it's over how I'll hike for Athabasca. And those seven greasy poilu, they're crazy to go to. And I'll give the wife the pickle tub I promised, and I'll ask her the price of mink and marten and the run of caribou. And I'll get my traps in order, and I'll start to work anew. For I've had my fill of fighting, and I've seen the nation scattered, and an army swung to slaughter, and a river red with gore, and a city all a-smolder, and as if it really mattered. For the lake is yonder dreaming, and my cabin's on the shore. And the dogs are leaping madly, and the wife singing gladly, and I'll rest in Athabasca, and I'll leave it nevermore. And I'll leave it nevermore.
Thank you.
My time is short, my ship's at sea. Already seem like ghosts to me. My millions mock me, I am poor. As any beggar at my door. My vast dominion I resign. 6 feet of earth to claim as mine. Brooding with shoulders bitter bowed. There are no pockets in a shroud. God, let me purge pure my heart and be of heaven's hope a part, flinging my fortune's foul increase to fight for pity, love, and peace. Oh, that I could with healing fare. Pledge to poverty and prayer. Cry high above the cringing crowd. Ye fools, be not by mammon cowed. There are no pockets in a shroud. Hearts are resonant and ring to war's romance. Hear ye the story of a boy, a peasant boy of France. A lad uncouth and warped with toil, yet who when trial came could feel within his soul upleap and soar the sacred flame. Could stand upright and scorn and smite as only heroes may. Oh, hearken, let me try to tell the tale of Jean Desprez. With fire and sword, the Teuton horde was ravaging the land. and there was darkness and despair, grim death on every hand. Red fields of slaughter sloping down to ruin's black abyss, the wolves of war and evil fang, and little did they miss. And on they came with fear and flame to burn and loot and slay, until they reached the red roof croft, the home of Jean Desprez. Rout out the village, one and all, the Uhlan captain said. Behold, some hand has fired a shot, my trumpeter is dead. Now shall they Prussian vengeance know, now shall they rue the day. For by the sacred German slain, 10 of these dogs shall pay. They drove the cowering peasants forth, women and babes and men. And from the last, with many a jeer, the captain chose E10. 10 simple peasants, bowed with toil, they stood they knew not why, against the gray wall of the church, hearing their children cry. Hearing their wives and mothers wail, with faces dazed they stood. A moment only, ready fire, they weltered in their blood. Was one who gazed unseen, who heard the frenzied cries, who saw these men in Sabbaths fall before their children's eyes. A Zouave wounded in a ditch, and knowing death was nigh, he laughed with joy, ah, here is where I settle, ere I die. He clutched his rifle once again, and long he aimed, and well, a shot beside his victims 10, the Uhlan captain fell. They dragged the wounded Zouave out, their rage was like a flame. With bayonets they pinned him down until their major came. A blonde, full-blooded man he was, and arrogant of eye. He stared to see with shattered skull his favorite captain lie. They do not finish him so quick, this foreign swine, he cried. Go nail him to the big church door, he shall be crucified. With bayonets through hands and feet, they nailed the Zouave there, and there was anguish in his eyes and horror in his stare. Water, a single drop, he moaned, but how they jeered at him and mocked him with an empty cup, and saw his sight grow dim. And as in agony of death, with blood his lips were wet, the Prussian major gaily laughed and lit a cigarette. But mid the white-faced villagers who cowered in horror by, was one who saw the woeful sight, who heard the woeful cry. Water, one little drop I beg, for love of Christ who died. It was the little Jean Desprez who turned and stole aside. He was a little barefoot boy who came with cup abrim, and walked up to the dying man and gave the drink to him. A roar of rage, they seize the boy, they tear him fast away. The Prussian major swings around, no longer is he gay. His teeth are wolfishly agleam, his face all dark with spite. Go shoot the brat, he snarls, that dare defy our Prussian might. Yet stay, I have another thought, I'll kindly be and spare. Quick, give the lad a rifle charged, and set him squarely there. And bid
made him shoot and shoot to kill. Haste make him understand. The dying dog he fain would save shall perish by his hand. And all his kindred they shall see, and all shall curse his name, who bought his life at such a cost, the price of death and shame. They brought the boy wild-eyed with fear, they made him understand. They stood him by the dying man, a rifle in his hand. Make haste, said they, the time is short, and you must kill or die. The major puffed his cigarette, amusement in his eye. And then the dying zouave heard and raised his weary head. Shoot, son, 'twill be the best for both. Shoot swift and straight, he said. Fire first and last, and do not flinch, for lost a hope am I. And I shall murmur, vive la France, and bless you where I die. Half blind with blows, the boy stood there. He seemed to swoon and sway. Then in that moment woke the soul of little Jean de Bray. He saw the woods go sheening down, the larks were singing clear, and oh, the scents and sounds of spring, how sweet they were, how dear. He felt the scent of new-mown hay, a soft breeze fanned his brow. Oh God, the paths of peace and toil, how precious were they now. The summer days and summer ways, how bright with hope and bliss. The autumn, such a dream of gold, and all must end in this. This shining rifle in his hand that shambles all around. The zouave there with a dying glare, the blood upon the ground. The brutal faces round him ringed, the evil eyes aflame. That Prussian bully standing by as if he watched a game. Make haste and shoot, the major sneered, a minute more I give. A minute more to kill your friend if you yourself would live. Saw a barefoot boy with blanched and twitching face. They did not see within his eyes the glory of his race. The glory of a million men who for fair France have died. The splendor of self-sacrifice that will not be denied. Yet he was but a peasant lad, and oh, but life was sweet. Your minute's nearly gone, my lad, he heard a voice repeat. Shoot, shoot, the dying zouave moaned. Shoot, shoot, the soldier said. And then Jean de Bray reached out and shot the Prussian major dead. With a heart of lead and bow, poor Alphonse went to war. And though it's true he did not know what he was fighting for, he grieved because unto Marie he'd been but 3 weeks wed. Tough luck, another three, and he was listed with the dead. Marie was free if she were fain another spouse to choose, but if she dared to wed again, her pension she would lose. And so to mourn she did prefer, and widow to remain, like many dames whose husbands were accounted with the slain.
that she was prayed for motherhood with hips and belly broad, and should have borne a brawny brood to render thanks to God. If with valor Alphonse had not fallen in the fray, proud Marie would have been a glad great-grandmother today. Yet maybe it is just as well she has not bred her kind. The ranks of unemployment swell and flats are hard to find. For every year the human race richly we see increase, and wonder how they'll find a place. Well, that's the curse of peace. Let us hail the gods of war with joy and jubilation, who favor foolish mankind, for they prune the population. Let us thank the hungry guns forever belching doom, to slaughter bloodily our sons to give us elbow room. So sweet, we watched the troops returning through our tears. There was triumph, triumph, triumph down the scarlet glittering street, and you scarce could hear the music for the cheers. And you scarce could see the housetops for the flags that flew between. Bells were pealing madly to the sky. Everyone was shouting for the soldiers of the Queen, and the glory of an age was passing by. And then there came a shadow, swift and sudden, dark and drear. The bells were silent, not an echo stirred. The flags were drooping sullenly, the men forgot to cheer. We waited and we never spoke a word. The sky grew darker, darker, till from out the gloomy wreck there came a voice that checked the heart with dread. Tear down, tear down your bunting now, and hang up sable black. They are coming, it's the army of the dead. They are coming, it's the army of the dead. They were coming, gaunt and ghastly, sad and slow. They were coming, all the crimson wrecks of pride, with faces seared and cheeks red smeared, and haunting eyes of woe, and clotted holes the khaki couldn't hide. Oh, the clammy brow of anguish, the livid foam flecked lips, the reeling ranks of ruin swept along, the limb that trailed, the hand that failed, the bloody fingertips, and oh, the dreary rhythm of their song. They left us on the belt side, but we felt we couldn't stop. On this, our England's crowning festal day, were the men of Magus Fontaine, were the men of Spion Cup, Colenso, were the men who had to pay, were the men who paid the blood price. Shall the grave be all our gain? You owe us long, and heavy is the score.
then cheer us for our glory now, and cheer us for our pain, and cheer us as you never cheered before. The folks were white and stricken, each tongue seemed weighted with lead. Each heart was clutched in hollow hand of ice. And every eye was staring at the horror of the dead, the pity of the men who paid the price. They were come to mock us in the first flush of our peace. Through writhing lips their teeth were all agleam. They were coming in their thousands, oh would they never cease. I closed my eyes and then it was a dream. I closed my eyes and then it was a dream. There was triumph, triumph, triumph down the scarlet gleaming street. The town was mad. A man was like a boy. A thousand flags were flaming where the sky and city meet. A thousand bells were thundering the joy. There was music, mirth, and sunshine, but some eyes shone with regret. And while we stun with cheers our homing braves, O God, in thy great mercy, let us never more forget the graves they left behind, the bitter graves. The graves they left behind, the bitter graves.